Hi, I'm Glenn. This is Tech Savvy for Seniors. And today we're going to talk about devices that hook up seamlessly with your Google Home, and they're called Matter Enabled. So in making this video about Matter Enabled devices, I wanted to make sure that what I was telling you was actual fact, because I've watched a number of videos about Matter, and although it sounds absolutely incredible, I wanted to try it for myself to make sure that it is absolutely incredible. The one thing everybody says about Matter-enabled devices is they hook up seamlessly to your home environment. So if that environment is Google or Google Home, then you need your Nest Hub close by so that you can actually hook up a Matter-enabled device. So what is a Matter-enabled device? Well, it could be an outlet, a plug-in, it could be a light bulb, it could be a fan speed control, a light switch. Many, many devices made for your home today are Matter-enabled devices. But you also have to make sure that you look for this symbol to show you that it is Matter-enabled. Why is that? Well, if it's not Matter-enabled, then you'll have to go through the install on the normal routine, which means you'll have to download the program from the manufacturer that you bought the item from first. With a Matter-enabled device, you should be able to hook it up very quickly to your Google Home or your Alexa or whatever your home hub is that you're deciding to use. So I've watched a few videos about this, and the concept is awesome. Let's put a very quick little stop there, because I've recently read on a device that I'm going to show you in a couple of minutes that you have to hook up also to the manufacturer in order to get the latest firmware downloads. That's important. So I guess in the long run, you do end up, yes, saving some time and saving some hassle by going through a lot of individual steps, as we'll talk about in a moment, and I've already shown you in one of my previous videos, where you have to go in, search out the manufacturer from your Google Home device, and hook it up from there. So without any further delay, let's get started, and I hope you enjoy the video. Don't forget, I need you to hit like and subscribe, please. That'd really help me out a lot. Here's the screen from my iPad I decided to share with you. So we can go directly to Google Home, open it up, and lo and behold, they're set up your device with the Matter symbol showing here. So it detected immediately that I want to set up this particular plug. So let's hit the setup button. Asking me, do I want to set this device up on my Google account? And I do. So I'm just going to say, I agree. And now it's going to look for the Google Home. It says it's an accessory. It shows a picture of it, and it wants me to add it to my Google Home, which I'm going to do. As you can see, it's taking a moment. So here we can now put a name to this particular plugin. So let's call it, because I already have so many of these plugs, let's call it Meross, or Meross, M-E-R-O-S-S. And we'll call it Meross 1. Let's say done. Let's continue. And that was as simple as that. It added it directly to my Google Home. I am impressed so far with that. So now it's asking me where the device is actually going to be set up. I'm going to say office, because I am going to keep it down in my office area. So we'll select office and say next. So now it's getting my device ready. I think this is pretty impressive, and it is pretty fast, because I'm not working anywhere near my home hub. It's upstairs in another area of the house. So it just goes to show you that this didn't take long at all. So now when I go to my devices, I should see Meross, and I should see it in the office. Let's have a look and see, just to make sure it ended up where we want it to end up. So as you can see, I have a lot of devices hooked up. And here we go. We have Meross 1 hooked up, and I've just shut it off with the touch of a finger. And I've turned it back on with touch of a finger. I'm very pleased with this hookup and this setup. It was fast, it was efficient, and I'm looking forward to using this product. So off we go. I'm going to go now and have a look at the Meross program. I took the liberty of setting up the Meross product already. So here we go. I'm going to touch on Meross, and it says, first things first, how to set it up, set up solutions. Right now, I don't have anything set up. So I'm going to add, I'm going to allow it to access my Bluetooth. I'm going to add the smart plug to it. This adding process may take 1 minute. You can find the newly added device on my homepage. Let's see if it actually takes a minute. As you can see here, Meross offers quite a large number of different items that you can purchase from here. I said add the smart plug to it. I'm going to go to my home. It hasn't added it as of yet. Ah, but it's here now. So that was just slightly under 1 minute. And here I can control my Meross plug from here if I want to. So altogether, everything worked seamlessly, exactly the way it was described to work. I hooked up the Meross smart plug directly to my Google Home, and I had no issues with it whatsoever in the setup. So that I'm very happy with. Thanks everyone for watching the video today. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I've enjoyed delivering it to you. Don't forget, hit like and subscribe. This is Glenn, Tech Savvy for Seniors. Have a great day.